In this video, I'll be constructing decision trees using SilverDecisions. Go to solverdecisions.pl, select a language, and click Run. You'll be directed to this page with an empty canvas. I'll start by constructing a decision tree for this payoff table. To begin, right-click on any part of the canvas and click Add Decision Node. You will see this double exclamation mark indicating that the work is not done because every node needs to be connected to a terminal node. Since we have two states of nature here, I'm going to add two chance nodes. So right-click on the decision node and click Add Chance Node. Right-click again and add another chance node. I'm going to right-click on the top node, add a terminal node, and another terminal node. I'm going to click on the top branch here, which is referred to as Edge in this software. Note that the branch became blue and bold to indicate that it is selected. I'll label it as High. Enter a 500 payoff and a 0.6 probability. Note that the probability down here automatically changed to 0.4. I'm going to click on the bottom branch or Edge, label it Low, and change the payoff to 600. I can add terminal nodes to this second node like I did the first, or I can just copy and paste. So I right-click on the top node to copy and see what happens when I paste on the second one. It adds the node with another branch, showing that the correct way to paste in this software is to paste on the preceding node. I'm going to right-click and delete this node. Then right-click and paste on the preceding decision node. I'm going to click on the high branch and change the payoff to 750, then click on the low branch and change that payoff to 350. The probability is already 0.4 and does not need changing. I'm going to click on the top decision branch and label it Make, and label the lower one Buy. Note how the Buy branch is highlighted green to indicate that it is the preferred decision. The Buy branch is also assigned the probability of 1, while the Make branch is assigned 0, to indicate that Buy is chosen over Make. And you can see the better expected value under the decision node here. Now, suppose it costs $100 to make and $200 to buy. I can click on the Make branch and change the payoff to -100, and on the Buy branch, -200. You see now that the Make alternative is chosen, since 540 minus 100 is 440, which is greater than 590 minus 200, which gives 390. This software also has a nice undo and redo buttons here. I'm going to click the undo button twice, and you can see how the last two changes I made were reverted. By default, payoffs are treated as profits, so maximization is the default rule here. If payoffs are costs, you can click the drop-down and select Mean. You can see here that it selects 540 over 590. Lastly here, I'm going to show one other cool thing that can be done in this software. If I add another chance node, it shows at the bottom by default. If I want, I can move it to the middle or to the top. That's a lot of flexibility. In part 2 of this video, I will be constructing a multi-stage decision tree and showing some nice features in these settings. Thanks for watching.